story of my father and a very tragic event in his life where he was driving this car and when I was recently home for Christmas this past winter, I saw the car, which was still in my parents' garage, and I was really interested in the way that this central character in that story continues to exist. It's a piece of evidence from that narrative, where I asked him about this event that happened in 1970, where he and some friends were driving home on Christmas night around midnight, and they were coming back from a double date, and they pulled up behind a car. It was moving very slow, and then they passed it, and the car followed them, attempted to race them. They raced home to his friend's house. My father got out to see what they wanted, and without a word, they just rolled down the window and out with a knife and stabbed him in the heart.
The chest.
Yeah, so that's why the scar in the middle of the chest. So he's had many heart surgeries since. So the idea of the police, this is the newspaper the next day from 1970. The clipping, yeah, so I have a Xerox of it. And then I have a folder with photocopies of the police report about the event. This drawing, Cops, is not specifically that event, but I've been feeling there's been a lot in the news lately about police and police violence, and I realized I was thinking a lot about the work that the police were doing with my father's story, that they were trying to find the person who did it, but they didn't find him. They never found the person who stabbed him. So I was thinking about that, but I was also thinking about sort of contemporary events. So that's why this character is sort of anonymous. You don't know whether he could be someone in the past relating to my father's story, or he could be someone who's the police are arresting or kind of giving a hard time to. The navy pea coat that my dad was wearing when he was stabbed, my grandmother, who grew up during the Depression in the United States, never wanted to throw anything away. So she washed it, she had it laundered to wash the blood out, and then sewed the hole shut where the knife was. So I was imagining him, before she had sewed it, the hole up, kind of clowning around a little bit and poking his hole through the wound. It's kind of a reverse. But I also was interested that it was as though there was a puncture in the actual canvas. As though the canvas had been stabbed. Mm-hmm. So that the body of the canvas and his body were somehow the same. So this one is an invented scenario of me and my father conversing through the Camaro. So this is the window. It's very overlarge. This is the window of the car rolled down. And then my face reflected in the glass. And then this is him behind. When I was younger, I remember sitting around the car, looking under the hood. He had a different Camaro as well that we would go out and, he would work on. I had no idea what he was doing. But this is a sort of posture we would adopt, either side of the car, talking about it. I did all of these paintings of my father's car, obviously. But in my home, I have my bicycle, which is kind of my mode of transportation. And so if the car is sort of an extension of my father, I wanted the bike to be an extension of me. But there's also a memorial sense in the show. So in the US there's a way, if someone is killed on a bike, they're hit by a car and they die, their friends will paint a bicycle white and put plastic flowers on it and a placard and lock it to a post at the site where the accident happened, and it's called a ghost bike. Spatially, I also feel like there's the painting. Part of what I like about it is the way in which this space behind it is cut paper, and the fence is actually physically behind. When I'm riding the subway or walking around, I always carry this little sketchbook, and I make drawings of people. I'll be on the train and I'll sketch someone. So these paintings were all happening, they were coming immediately out of the sketchbook. And they felt a little bit like I was creating a cast that I might work with later. To me, they're character studies. Him, I was thinking a bit of the drawing of my father. set in the 1970s, but then he just turned into a bulkier.